Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be seeing about how to do a floral anniversary cake. Before that, if you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon so that you get notifications of all my new videos. So let's get started with the cake now. So I am starting with a crumb coated cake and just frosting the top with whipped cream. Then I'll be doing the same on the sides. If you want a detailed video on how I'm doing this and also about whipped cream basics, you can go ahead and check out those on my channel. I will drop a link on the top. We also have other videos about whipped cream, piping basics and everything. Make sure you do check them out too. So now I'm done with using my palette knife. Now I'm going to scrape it to get the smooth finish. I'm doing on the sides first and then I'll be doing it on the top with a palette knife. Once I get my edges clean and I'm happy with the finish, I'm good to go. You may have to do it multiple times to get a clean finish, but once you do, ta-da! Now let's quickly clean the board and then go to the next step. Step one is to mark the torsos of the couple on the cake top. You can either do it freehand or you can try cutting it out on a butter paper and then stenciling it carefully and removing the butter paper from the top of the cake. Or you can also use fondant paint on it and just simply place that on your cake. Here I am marking the couple's torso freehand with a sharp tool. You can either do this as well if you're confident. Once the design is ready, it's time to pipe. I'll be starting by piping the skin color onto the parts of skin. I'm not filling up the skin part, I'm just outlining those parts. Other parts like dress, hair and everything, I'll be filling them in. In case you're following like I am doing and piping only the outlines, keep a steady hand so that the lines are not wiggly. Here's the oops moment. Keep rotating the cake to conveniently pipe and be careful not to touch the top of the cake or else it might get spoiled. And now it's time to take another color. Now I've taken this lovely coral for the dress color. You can choose whatever color you like. I'll be filling this in, not just outlining. I've done the same to the man's suit as well. That's a dark blue in color. Now I'm going to repeat it for the hair. First for the man, then for the lady. When using dark black color, make sure you're very careful because just a slight touch of it tints anything on the cake. Make sure you fill in all the gaps before you start to smoothen it out, because if there are any gaps, once you smoothen it, they don't come even. Now take a wet brush and slightly dab on the cream you have already piped so that it smooths out on itself. Go from the lightest color to the darkest color so that there is no tint. Next step is to take a sharp tool and then mark how your gown goes. Here we are using flowers as gown, so you can mark the outlines on where and how you want the flowers to go. You can go wider, you can go longer, that's up to you. Here I am going to be using piping nozzles to pipe my flowers. To know about nozzles and their usage, you can go check out the piping 101 video wherein I talk all about nozzles and how to use them. I'm simply doing a 5-petal flower and I'm using the green cream to place it on the cake as well. You can use scissor, fork or a palette knife to lift and place it on the cake. And don't worry about the piping part, there are videos coming out soon on detailed step-by-step process on how to pipe different flowers, not just this, the roses, the dahlias, the marigolds and many more. So we'll just go ahead and pipe few more flowers of different sizes and different types and we'll be placing them on the cake. I am going another layer here instead of going out as a 5-petal. I am just adding one more layer and also place them randomly so not all the colors come in the same place. I'll be using different colors later in the video. I'll be using yellows and peach as well. And while you're placing the flowers onto the cake, make sure you gently press them down so that they stay in place. I prefer using palette knife, pick smaller flowers, and scissors to pick bigger flowers because it gives more control. Now I'm piping a few petals here and there. We are now repeating the same with another color, a lovely peach. We are using few of the same flowers that we did and few other new flowers as well. Try and make it as random as possible in terms of the size, in terms of the color, and in terms of the type of the flower you're piping. Here comes the bright and sunny yellow. For all the flowers, I'm using green as a base right, because it gives this natural shady undertone for the flowers, which I absolutely love. But if you're not willing to have it, you can always use the same color for the base as well. Now that the flowers and petals are all in place, I'm going to fill the gaps with green dots and just simply piping dots of green. Then I'll be filling them in with white dots on the top, which is slightly smaller than the green, to make them look like filler flowers. After this, you can use few draggies to fill in the centers of the flower if you want, and place your tag wherever you are willing to have it, and then you're done. Isn't it just lovely? Though it looks like it's a very complicated cake, now you know how easily you can do this. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please share your comments in the comment section below. I'd be waiting to hear from all of you. Thanks for now. Signing off. Love, Ajita.